district leaders have not announced where their proposed power lines would go after being blocked by the Balsams earlier this year. But the Forest Society says they think they know.
But we have clear evidence of what that route is, and we're going to be showing that to you today.
This was the original route proposed in the late fall of 2011.
The Forest Society unveiled a map at Monday's press conference showing four key parcels of land, all privately owned, announcing that all four landowners have agreed to conservation easements that add up to 1,500 acres in Coos County.
I think we think it's an important move for the state of New Hampshire to make it clear that we intend to protect New Hampshire's scenic landscapes from the top to the bottom.
Now the push is on to raise $2.5 million to pay for those easements. Northern Pass project leaders say they've dealt with challenges like this before.
We've had obstacles from the Forest Society put in front of us before, and we simply have to work around them. This is a very significant project and one that is worth considering.
The Forest Society says they're not opposed to bringing hydroelectric power into New Hampshire and New England, but stress this is a private, for-profit venture that would permanently alter the landscape of the North Country.
To date, we feel that Northern Pass has been unwilling to look at those alternatives. And I think, you know, burying is maybe an opportunity. Putting it along public highways is perhaps an alternative.
The Forest Society and others, as part of the Climate Action Plan in 2009, voted for this very sort of project. This is our proposal.
Martin Murray went on to say that Northern Pass intends to explore their current proposal before shifting to new ideas. They will present their proposal for a new route for public scrutiny and federal scrutiny by the end of the year. Now, the Forest Service, they need to raise $2.5 million by October 31st. Live in the newsroom, Amy Covino. WMUR News 9.